Hello children, welcome again for the new session of math chapter 3 data handling. In the previous video you have learned exercise 3.2 three questions. Today we are going to continue exercise 3.2. okay children, let's start exercise 3.2. question number 4. The run scored in a cricket match by 11 players is as follows: 6, 15, 120, 50, 100, 80, 10, 15, 8, 10, 15. These are the scores. So question is like that: find the mean, mode and median of this data. Are the three datas are same or not? Okay, first of all we have to arrange this run score in the ascending order. Let's see how it is. Starting from smallest number, 6, 8, 10, 10, 15, 15, 15, 50, 8, 0, 80, 100, 120. So this way we have to write in the ascending order. Now, you are already learned previously the equation to find out the mean. Mean is equal to total runs upon number of players. And here 11 players are there and 11 player scores also given here. So we have to add the runs. So let us see that how to do that. Total runs means all the runs we have to plus it. 6 plus 8 plus 10 plus 10 plus 15 plus 15 plus 15 plus 50 plus 80 plus 100 plus 120 upon 11. 11 means number of players. So after adding the runs, we are getting 429 runs upon number of players, that is 11. So if we divide 429 upon 11, we will get the answer 39. That means the mean of the runs, that is 39 runs. So the mean of the given data is 39 runs. So first answer we already got. The mean of the given data, that is 39 runs. The equation is like that: total runs upon number of players. Okay children, next we have to find out the mode. You just have a look on the scores given in the question and you have to see that which number is repeating maximum time. Okay, you can see that 15 is repeating maximum number of times. How many times repeating? 3 times. So we can say that the mode of the given data is a 15. That means 15 runs. Okay, now the one more question we have to find out the answer of that. What is that? Median. So for that you just see that total how many observations are there? 11 observations are there. So we have to find out the middle observation, that is the median of the given data. If it is 11 observations are there, the middle one, it will be 6th observation. All of you look at the question and say which is the 6th observation. Yes, of course, 15. So the 6th observation is the median. The 6th observation is a 15. So we can say that the median of the given data is a 15. That means 15 runs. Okay children, now we already got all the three answers. Means we got 39 runs, mode we got 15 runs, median we got 15 runs. And what is the question? Last question they are asking like that: are the three are same? No, all the three answers are not the same. Here mode and median are the same because 15 runs are there, but the mean is 39 runs. Okay children, this way we have to find out the answer. Means a total number of runs upon number of players, that will get the answer of mean. And mode means which observation is repeating maximum number of times, that is means mode. And median means the middle observation, that is the median. So this way we have to find out mean, mode and median. I hope you have understood how to find out this answer. Okay, Next, question number 5. Tell whether the statement is true or false. Number 1. The mode is always one of the numbers in a data. Yes, that is true. Second question. The mean is one of the numbers in a data. False. Number 3. The median is always one of the numbers in a data. That is false. When it is coming true, the statement is true only if the number of observation is odd. If the odd numbers are given, then we can take the middle observation. If the observations are given in odd numbers, then we can say that the median is always one of the numbers in a data. Otherwise, the statement is wrong. False. Fourth one, the data 6, 4, 3, 8, 9, 12, 13, 9 has mean 9. The given statement is true or false. That is false, because if you are adding all these data, will get 64. So 64 divided by 8, the mean is getting 8, but the given statement, it is given 9. So the given statement is false. Okay. Children, we have completed exercise 3.2. Now let us start exercise 3.3, question number 1. Use the bar graph to answer the following question. Here one bar graph is given. Looking at the bar graph, you have to answer the following question. Let us see which are the question. First question, which is the most popular pet? You have a look on the screen, on the graph, and say that which is the most popular pet, which animal getting more number. It is so clear that from the graph, cats are liked by most of the students. How many students are liking cats? 10 students. So we can say that cat is the most popular pet. Okay. Second question, how many students have dog as a pet? How many students are liking dogs as a pet? Look at the graph and say, you can say so clearly, how many students? Yes, A student. So A students have dog as a pet. Okay children, this way we have to find out the answer from the given graph. Okay, let us continue exercise 3.3, question number 2. Here also we have to find out the answer from the given graph. Read the bar graph which shows the number of books sold by a bookstore during 5 consecutive years and answer the following question. Here 5 consecutive continuous years are given. We have to find out the answer after looking at the graph. 1989, 1990, 1991, 1992, 1993. These 5 continuous years are given. Okay, what is the first question? About how many books were sold in the year 1989, 1990, 1992? Okay, how many books are sold in 1989? You have to see the graph and say, we can see that in 1989, 180 books were sold. And 180 books were sold in 1989. Okay. Let's see the next one. 1990, how many books were sold? See the graph and say, we can say that 470 books were sold in 1990. The third one, how many books were sold in 1992? Look at the graph. You can say that 230 books were sold in 1992. Okay. The second question, in which year were about, not exact, about 475 books sold and about 225 books sold. That means it is not exact 475 and 225. It is just near that. See that first one, 475 books were sold in the year 1990. It is already given 470 book, but exactly not 475. It is just near 475. That is the year 1990. The same way, 225 books were sold in 1992. Actually, in 1992, 230 books were sold. But here asking about, just near. So we can say, in 1992 about 225 books were sold. Okay children, this way we have to find out the answer after looking at the graph. Okay children, next question. In which years were fewer than 250 books sold? In which years less than 250 books were sold? Just have a look on the graph and say in the years 1989, we have already written the answer. How many books were sold? 180. So that means that 180 is less than 250. And one more year is there, 1992, how many books were sold? 230. So that also less than 250. So in the years 1989 and 1992, less than 250 books were sold. Okay. Now next question, can you explain how would you estimate the number of books sold in 1989? Actually, in 1989, 180 books, but it is not exactly shown on the graph. It is shown, but not clearly. We have to find out that. But the unit is already given. One unit is equal to 100 books. That means in between 100 and 200, five columns are there. Five squares, small squares are there. So, one column, that is considering as 20. So 1 upon 5, that is equal to 20. Then 4 upon 5, 4 columns we can take it as a 80. Understood children what I am saying? 1 column 20, 2 column 40, 3 column 60, then 4 column it is coming 80. Okay, 1 plus 4 out of 5, 1 column, 1 full it is already there 100. Then after 100, 4 small columns are there, that will consider as a 80. So 100 plus 80, that is equal to 180 books. Okay, this way we have to find out the answer of fourth question. I hope all of you have understood this question and answers. Okay, we are winding up the session now. I will come with another video. Till then, take care, keep learning. All this answer please note down in your notebook and learn properly for the test. Okay children, bye.